Welcome to Conversations Live. For more than a decade, we've brought you the best in books, entertainment, celebrity interviews, and current events. When the movers and shakers of the world have something to say to you, they say it to us first. Here's your host, Cyrus Webb.
And welcome back, everyone, to Conversations Live. I'm your host, Cyrus Webb. Glad you all could join us once again. This is for a radio audience here in Mississippi, WYAD 94.1 FM and WYADonline.com. We're glad that you all could be with us. Also, just joining us are our friends at iHeartRadio on Amazon Music Podcast. We're glad you all could be with us as well. This is part of our four-year health segment here at WYAD. Today, we're talking about metastatic breast cancer and new data that's available. Metastatic breast cancer is the most serious form of the disease and occurs when the cancer has spread beyond the breast to other parts of the body, such as the brain, bones, or liver. Well, here to talk to us today about some new data that is out and treatment options, we're excited to welcome two special guests to our program. We have Dr. Denise Yardley, as well as Shirley Mertz, who's the president of Metastatic Breast Cancer Network. They're going to share some valuable information with you for yourself, as well as for your loved ones. Thanks to the two of you for the time. Really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Dr. Yardley, I want to start with you. What does overall survival normally mean in the context of metastatic breast cancer?
So in the context of metastatic breast cancer, it's a diagnosis of an advanced stage of disease that has spread to other parts of the body. And unfortunately, with that diagnosis comes the fact that the patient's treatable but not curable. And so when we look at treatment options for patients, we really embrace looking at drugs and treatments that can offer a benefit to the patients in terms of the value of that drug in prolonging that patient's life and how long you might live with this diagnosis of metastatic breast cancer. So when we look at new treatments and new categories of drugs advancing the you know data for our metastatic breast cancer, one such drug, Kisqali, has now demonstrated the longest median overall survival in patients with metastatic hormone receptor positive HER2 negative disease. And so when we see that this drug controlling the disease and offering patients a median or an average of 5 years of survival, clearly having patients that are living beyond that endpoint, I think is a significant milestone for patients, as we're talking about patients not living months or weeks. We're talking about years and years and years. So patients can plan and have that ability to think about their next vacations, the weddings, the graduations, the births in the family. And when you say the medication can offer this on average, such as Kisqali, over a median of 5 years, I think it's a really exciting endpoint for a drug on a patient with advanced breast cancer.
That's great information, Dr. Yardley. Shirley, I want to bring you into the conversation. As I mentioned, the work that you've been able to do as the president of the Metastatic Breast Cancer Network, what do advancements like this in treatment mean to you in the community?
Well, as the doctor pointed out, there is no cure for metastatic breast cancer. And so patients who receive the diagnosis face ongoing treatments. And while some treatments work longer than others, cancer cells are relentless, and they often get to the point where they can overcome and resist the treatment, which means then that the cancer that might be in my liver or my lungs starts to progress again. And that obviously is a very awful time for the patient. So why an advancement like Kisqali is important is it means that for patients who have hormone-positive breast cancer, they can look to talking with their doctor about the possibility that a new treatment might help them. And I really urge, as a patient advocate, I really urge every metastatic patient to talk to their doctor and to know what type of subtype they have and how it is treated so that they can interact and with the doctor to select the best treatment. So in sum, you know, having a new treatment gives you hope. If you knew this was the last treatment ever, you know, that would just create terrible despair. So this is a new advancement with new hope, and I urge patients to investigate it if they fit that subtype.
Shirley, you mentioned something that we've been talking about a lot recently in this program, and that is being able to advocate for your own health. So I want to ask you, how has living with metastatic breast cancer affected your quality of life or day-to-day activities?
Well, for me, and that's a great question. I'm so glad you asked it. I'm excited about that because for me, I was like every other patient. I was in despair, shock, anger. My diagnosis came after dealing with early stage breast cancer 12 years before that. So, why me? Why did it come back? But the key of go forward with is educating patients to be their best advocate. And that means, and I'll give you three or four tips. One, finding the best knowledgeable oncologist that you can, someone that you can work with who has a good rapport, who together you can respect and trust each other. And then also, knowledge is power. Know what your subtype is, and using the internet and educated sources, and there are many. My organization is one, and there are others. Look for information about what your subtype is about. What is driving the cancer? And so knowing your subtype, understanding what makes it grow, and if you have a good oncologist, you can sit down and talk about treatment choices. And finally, I would urge all patients not to ignore their psychological or mental well-being. This disease is like a roller coaster. You sometimes are going up and boy, you're feeling good. And then something happens, whether it's with a scan or whatever, and you feel, you're going down. So don't hesitate to ask for resources or help to deal with the mental feelings that you do have. And I really thank you for that question. That's an important one.
Well, I thank you for sharing a bit of your story and your advocacy work there, Shirley. Dr. Yardley, I want to ask you, when we're talking about these treatments, can you discuss the potential risk and benefits?
Yes. I think, the enthusiasm really with some of our medications, particularly like Kisqali, it's an oral therapy, and it partners with an anti-estrogen or hormone-blocking therapy. And I think the excitement is, it keeps patients really in the comfort and convenience of their home. It limits the amount of trips they need to make to their physician's office. It does, like any medication, require some monitoring. So we do check labs. The white blood cell count can lower a little bit. We may see some changes in some of the liver blood work. And so we do have patients come in and for regular checkups and have this monitored. There may be some fatigue. But all in all, as an oral therapy, it's quite well tolerated, and patients experience an excellent quality of life. And I think the other great enthusiasm is that it works in premenopausal, postmenopausal, male breast cancer patients. So it's an oral therapy that really hits the spectrum of all different walks of life of patients facing a diagnosis of metastatic hormone receptor positive breast cancer.
With some great information for our audience in our For Your Health segment today. Again, everyone, Dr. Denise Yardley and Shirley Mertz have been our guests and talking with us about not only, of course, the information about metastatic breast cancer, but also treatment options. Dr. Yardley, where can our audience go for more information?
They can go and look about Kisqali on Kisqali.com, which is Kisqali. And as always, we have patients really talk to their healthcare provider to see if this treatment or what other treatments may be appropriate for their case.
Well, thanks to the two of you for the time and the work you're doing, and looking forward to having the two of you back on the program again.
Thank you.
All right, and we thank your audience for tuning in to another great segment of Conversations Live, part of our News You Can Use segment here at WYAD 94.1 FM and WYADonline.com. Until next time, I'm your host, Cyrus Webb, saying, as always, enjoy your day, enjoy your life, enjoy your world. Thank you all for choosing Conversations Live. Now let's go make today amazing. Take care.